Hello everyone, I'm Tari Stevens. With me tonight in the broadcast booth, from Crossville itself, Mike Bobo. Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, to the Crossville High School Lions football. Mike, good to have you with us.
Thank you.
You and I are doing some play-by-play this year, and looking forward to seeing the Crossville High School have a successful season. We traveled to Ider tonight to pick up this first game for the season for both of these two teams. Mike, how important is it to get the team off to a good start right off the bat first of the season?
Well, it's really important to start off on a positive note because, you know, the first victory always means a lot to you. Right. You can build your season from that point on.
I know the Crossville High School has had two quarterbacks that could have started tonight, and the coach elected to go with number 13, Clint. And you see that as a problem anywhere down the line in case Clint got hurt, Josh come in?
Josh is doing a fine job. I think Clint, you know, him being a senior and all, may have a little bit more experience, you know, so shouldn't be a problem at all.
All right. I understand from the coach that they're going to be doing some running most of the time, so we look forward to seeing a ground game that just kind of eats up the yards.
Yeah, they got a big version fullback, Corey Dalrymple, quick tailback, and Mikey Wade, and Cody O'Dell also run the ball some. Big flanker, and Tyler Harper, big kid, so should be real exciting.
We're looking forward to it. These players may be a little bit nervous tonight. Fans in the stands may be a little bit nervous, first game of the season, but we think after that first snap, things will get under control and just have a good game of it.
Yeah, that's always that first game jitter. You know, I got them myself, so first game jitter. It's going to be exciting here, and I hope we have a lot of luck.
Folks, stay with us, if you would. We're coming to you now from the Ider Stadium as Ider takes on Crossville High School Lions. We'll be back in just a moment with more Crossville High School Lions football.
Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, to the first game of the 1995 Crossville High School football season. Tonight we're taking on the Ider Hornets. Coin toss has already been flipped. Ider has won, and they have deferred to the second half.
Roy Smith. Kicking off for Crossville, bringing the 35 Arthur.
22,
Brent Tinker. I think Arthur's going to run most of the kicking this year. He's going to be a player that plays kicker too.
I was watching him in the pregame warm-ups, and he was beating the ball pretty well. So I don't think they'll have a whole lot of trouble with him.
He's a big kid for a 10th grader.
Looks like both teams are just about lined up and ready to kick off.
Like Spurs said, a special thank you to the fans. Looks like we've got a stands full over there, which we normally do no matter where we go.
That looks good across the way.
Yeah, we always have a stands full.
And Todd Harper is going to the kickoff. And the ball is in the air. The 1995 season is underway.
Number 20, Roy
Smith, takes it up the middle.
We will start the number 82.
Takes it out to the 35-yard line.
Jimmy Green is going to stop. Like the both of them, Morris.
I didn't think anybody was going to be right there to catch him for a moment. One of his own players that like to make his way.
Starting to run with it. Crossville coming out to split four. Defense. I think he's going to start line up in a minute. We'll try out left tackle.
36 takes the ball. Out of the right tackle.
Dive up and won't stop.
Green with about a yard.
The defense is defensive ends are number 51, Joe Harvey. Number 41, Adam Carson. The tackles are number 30, Kevin Patterson. Number 55, Dusty Darnell. Get to the linebackers in the second down in a minute.
Set it down, about 8 yards to go. Ider comes up to the line of scrimmage. Jonathan Leonard is under the center. Takes the ball, pitch back to the tailback around the left end.
Nice stick.
I believe in that game, maybe a half an hour.
Last play.
Knockdown down,
number
42, Mikey Wade.
Looks like Crossville's putting up a pretty good defensive stop right here in the third in the ball game.
37.
Ider once again comes to the line of scrimmage, third down. They may be in a passing situation.
Number 10 takes the ball, pitches back to number 36. Running right in. He's got a first down. Down to the 40-yard line, the Crossville Lions.
Number 55, busted on out.
He just outrun everyone around that end, Mike.
That's going to awesome for Dusty, though.
Nobody around there to stop him.
He came from his tackle position, running down, so that was a good hustle.
First down for Ider.
He really contained, too.
On the cross for Lions, 41-yard line. Quarterback takes the ball. Draw right from there. Lane of about 9 yards on the play.
Matthew Road and Josh Robinson on the stop. It's a good pickup.
Number 25, pitch it for Ider, run the ball hard right up the middle.
Ider's got two good running backs and pitch it.
Comes up by second down, about a yard to go. Jonathan Leonard under the center. Once again, handoff right up the middle. I believe he's got his first down.
Stop by Darnell. They picked up the first down.
First down for the Ider Hornets. Looks like they're just moving the ball down the field. Now we're going to have some defensive stands right here.
Yeah, we're going to play a big play. A little turnover.
Ider breaks the huddle. They come out. Number 10 pitch. It takes a handoff.
An option. Oh, good play. Good play. Ball!
From the right.
Got it.
Can't
tell who got it. Number 22. Stephen Bowling.
Mighty looked like the quarterback just came down the line and was about ready to pitch the ball back to the tailback. He just got drugged down and lost the ball on the ground.
Yeah, it was Stephen Bowling. I'm sorry. Fine play. I didn't see who caused it. Did you see who caused it?
No, I couldn't tell who. Stripped it away from him. First down for the Crossville Lions on the wrong 31-yard line. Clint Cobbin, the quarterback tonight, gets his first starting roll. He pitches back to the tailback, around the left side, and it looks like a whole host of other players wrap him up.
That's a good receiver, defense.
Give you a starting lineup for the offense of Crossville. Quarterback number 13, Clint Cobbin. At fullback, number 34, Corey Dalrymple. Fullback number 42, Mikey Wade. At center is number 61, Matt Dendy. At right guard, number 65, Jason Cash. Right tackle, number 72, Justin Bowling. Number 21, at tight end, David Bowman in the flanker, is Tyler Harper. On the left side of guard, number 77, Kevin Holson back. Left tackle, number 52, Joey Scott, and it's split in, number 10, Dustin Rowell. And the ball's down on the floor.
Ready to go back. Recovered by number 45. It's a third long.
Just getting a little like Mikey Wade, ever got the handle on the ball. Puts Crossville in a long situation here, third down, long way to go.
Third and 20, it looks like.
Maybe it should just be a case of the jitters tonight, but it doesn't look like Cross was able to get things going on the first offensive possession.
Josh Waters split on this side.
Clint Cobbin comes up. He's under the center. He takes the ball. Good fake in the middle, and there's a pass.
Oh, yes.
Pass complete. Number 21, David Bowman.
Nice play.
He's down all the way to the Ider, 45-yard line. Good pass on the play by Clint Cobbin. Good catch in there also.
I thought it was, for a minute, he was going to throw it to Josh. So he was coming right behind David, so nice pickup.
All the way down to the Ider, 46-yard line. That was a big play there, Mike. That gave him a little boost of confidence.
That's breathing room, too.
Crossville comes up to the line of scrimmage. On Ider's 46-yard line, first down. He pitches back around the left end. He looks like he's got a hand. He may go all the way. He's down to the 30. And he's tackled in there finally, run out of bounds.
Pretty
at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, nice run, nice run.
Good run by Mikey Wade. Showed some speed getting around that hit left end. First down 10 once again.
Well, he goes out limping a little bit.
Following about the 23-yard line.
Odell's coming to the game.
That may be something that Crossville can learn this first half and be able to explore it all the whole game, maybe.
Yeah.
Outrunning those defensive guys around the end.
Well, maybe we can, maybe as the game goes on, we wear them down. They only got 18 players, so maybe we can wear them
down. That's one good thing about Crossville this year. They've got a good good line of players over there.
Right up the middle. Good pick that. Number 8, looks like.
Dalrymple had a good hard run off the belly. Looked like he had that ball tucked away real good.
He picked up first down.
10 yards on the play.
Can tell from up here. You'll have to excuse me if I go hollering.
Hey, that's all right, Mike.
I don't know if the fumble I go with a hollering ball.
Looks like Crawford's down about the 11-yard line. They break out of the huddle. Clint Cobbin comes up under center. He takes the snap.
So got
number
35.
Tyler Harper goes around the left end. Just a small gain of any on the play.
Couldn't get him outside. It's a good play, but if it's man, keep timing.
Only gained about a yard on that play. Sets up about second down, 9 yards to go.
Got to stay on the clock.
6 minutes, 24 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Score is 0-0. Ider had the ball first on their possession. Lined up with a fumble. Crossville recovered the fumble. Now trying to make a drive down the field.
Come out in the high formation. No penalty on the play. Got the play game against Crawford.
A little bit slow getting the play called in that time to the offense. Didn't allow them time to get up to the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty on the play. That'll set up about second down. 14 to go. Crossford breaks out of the huddle. Josh Wallace split out deep to the right side. Clint Cobbin under center. He drops back. He's going to pass.
Got Bowman in the middle. On the third.
Oh, it's kicked off by number 1 from Ider. He comes up to the left hash mark.
Tough luck.
Ider takes the ball down to about the 15-yard line.
Tough luck. Hey, just got him better than the left.
That was made by number 34.
It looked like he was open on the play, Mike. He just didn't make an accurate throw, right?
He was open with that smaller, just overthrowing him a little.
Easy pickoff for Ider. They take over.
We got a heat break.
With 5:56 left to go in the first quarter, we'll take timeout for a heat break. Be back after these messages. And we're back here at Ider Stadium. 5 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the first quarter. Ider has taken over after an interception. It's first down on their own 15-yard line.
Good stop.
Run up the middle.
Yeah, I think it was Dalrymple.
Looked like a gain of about 5 yards. 4 or 5 yards on the play. That'll make it about second down. 6 yards to go.
You're getting the outside linebackers, Cody Odell, 28, and 21, David Bowman. Inside linebackers, 34, Corey Dalrymple, 44, Mark Johnson. Corners are Josh Wallace, Stephen Moreland, and safeties, Mikey Wade.
Second down, 6 yards
to go. Up the middle, good stop by Dalrymple, and a whole host of them.
Looked like a good play that time by the defense.
Yeah, Bowman's in on it. Bowman's in on it. Good play.
Just a short gain on the play, maybe a yard. Brings up third down, 5 yards to go. Sure would help if Crossville make a good stop right here and get the ball back. They was driving down the field a while ago with a good drive. Jonathan Leonard comes up under center.
Good trap back this way.
Another trap, same play once again.
Good play. Who's that on the stop? I can't. Number 30.
21, David Bowman.
I believe he's going to be short on his first down, Mike. Bring up fourth down.
Kevin Patterson. Nice play by Kevin.
3 yards to go. Ider's going to have to drop back in punt formation.
Back deep to punt.
Mikey Wade's deep.
Keith Pritchett.
Mikey Wade.
To return the ball, number 42, Mikey Wade.
Ider's lined up in the punt formation. The snap, the low throw, but he gets it off. Mikey Wade takes it at his 50-yard line, and he's down immediately at the 49-yard line.
Listen, just call it. That's right.
Crossville's going to get good field position out of this. They're already in Ider's territory. Be first down, 10 yards to go.
That's good concentration on Mikey's part.
3 minutes, 55 seconds left to go in this first quarter.
We need to drive it down score.
Clint Cobbin comes in with a play from the sidelines. Break the huddle, come out to the line of scrimmage. Ider begins to set their defense. Pitch to the left side to Mikey Wade. He goes around the left end. Good gain on the play.
Good gain.
Gets about 8 yards on that carry. I don't believe Otter's been able to stop that since the game started, Mike.
And the one he drops, only one that's top.
Sets up about second down, 3 yards to go. Good first down carry. Cody Odell comes into the game to relieve Mikey Wade. Crossville's got some good running backs this time. They can relieve each other and not miss a step.
Patterson at fullback.
Cobbin drops back, hands the ball off to Cody Odell. He's got his first down. He gets down about the 34-yard line of Ider. First and 10 on the play now. Good little run by Cody Odell.
He was blocking up front, too.
He tucked the ball away. Wasn't no chance of him stripping it out. Josh Wallace comes into the game. He relieves Dustin Powell. Brings the play in. Crossville sprints to the line of scrimmage. Clint Cobbin goes up under center. First down for Crossville. Once again, hand off to Cody Odell.
Good play.
Good run out up the middle. Looks like the line may be doing some good blocking up there. Yeah, at a hole.
Great trap blocking there.
Good pickup on the play. Second down and less than a yard to go. Mikey Wade comes into the game, brings the play in, relieves Cody Odell. It's almost like Crossville's got a free play right here. They need a first down. Clint Cobbin comes up under center. Snap. Pitches back to Mikey Wade. He's around right in. He's in the open. He's down to the 10. He's down to the 5-yard line.
Good run. Good run.
That's a good hard run in there.
Yeah, big hole.
Once again, the line of scrimmage, they've done a good job blowing off and creating that little seam. Pretty good size hole there for Mikey Wade to break through. He only had about one man to beat. Just couldn't get around him before Ider. He kind of converged on him, made the stop. We got first down, goal to go for the Crossville High School Lions. 5 yards to get into the end zone. 1 minute, 12 seconds left in the first quarter. Looks like number 13.
They're going to take a timeout.
They're going to take a timeout. They want to make sure about what their play is. 1 minute, 6 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Score 0-0. We'll be right back after these messages. We're back from the timeout. Crossville took a timeout. First down, 5 yards to go to make it into the end zone. Ider Hornets make it back onto the field after the timeout.
Always makes you feel better to score first. That's what we need to do right here.
Had a good drive going the first time they touched the ball. Just threw an interception right down here almost where they're at right now. Got back down here real quick. Get back under the center. Hands back to Mike Wade.
couldn't
I thought he was going to have a hole open there for a moment, Mike.
It's 64 for Ider, but it's fine play.
No gain on the play. Looked like he had a little seam there for a moment, but sure did shut down in a hurry. Getting down close to under 30 seconds of the first quarter. Crossville has the ball on about the 5-yard line, second down.
The power eye formation. Here's Dodell.
Odell tried to go around the left end that time, and it seemed like the defense knew right where he was going.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I believe he lost a little on that.
You're going to let the clock run out, Morris.
And that winds down the first quarter. Here at Ider Stadium, the score is still 0-0. Crossville on the ball. They'll have the ball back. The second quarter begins on about the 5-yard line. It'll be third down. And we're back with the beginning of the start of the second quarter. Crossville has the ball now on the other end of the field. It's third down, 5 yards to go to cross the end zone line. Mike, you seem like Crossville had the ball a lot in that first quarter.
Yeah, it seemed like we controlled the ball pretty good. They just had the one drive on us there. Picked up a couple first downs, I believe, and so it was, we did okay. Just not being as we talked about earlier, not being an area game, but you still always want to win your first game. And of course, we got Geraldine and Sandrock in our area. We're 3A area 13, but you always want to win your first one.
Crossville's having to replace a lot of starters off that offense. I believe they lost about 10 starters last year.
Yeah, we got we had some pretty good depth last year, and these kids coming on and showing it now. So that's what we want. And we got some depth now.
Looks like Crossville has been able to. Looks like Crossville's been able to create some holes for running backs if they can just keep up that.
We definitely got the momentum right now. We just need to stick it in the end zone. Power football, nothing like it.
Both teams back out on the field. Crossville has the play came in. Number 13, Clint Cobbin, quarterback in the drive down the field. He goes up under center.
Still got a power eye offense.
He takes the snap, turns to his right. He's going to pass the ball.
Wide open. Everybody in the touchdown.
Touchdown.
Good job.
Touchdown for number 21, David Bowman. Mike made that look simple.
Yeah, that was really good. Really good play action. Stuck it in there, pulled it out. Fine job.
Crossville gets on the board first. 6-0 here. 11:54 into this second quarter.
Hopefully, things going to do the PATs. He kicked, I believe it was a 42-yarder last year.
It sure was.
He's got a lot of leg strength for a 10th grader.
Crossville's lined up for the extra point.
Probably jinx him talking about it.
The snap, the hold is good.
Good. Good job.
And the kick is good.
Right.
And Crossville takes the lead now, 7-0 over the Ider Hornets. Second quarter action coming to you right here, folks. Looks like we've got a good ball game on our hands. We'll be back in just a few moments. We're back here after the Crossville score. Ider will be getting the ball on the kickoff.
That was a good call by Coach Garman.
So took a timeout right then, and a few moments ago, went to the sideline, decided what he wanted to do after the first quarter break, came back out, and one play later, they go into the end zone with a pass. David Bowman catches that. Crossville lined up now, about ready to kick off. And the kick is up. Pretty good kick down to about the 5-yard line. Number 22 takes the ball around the left side. Number 40 makes the tackle out to about the 25-yard line.
Takes Martin. Nice play.
Takes Martin made a good play over. I thought he was going to get around him there for a second, but he kind of reached out and grabbed him, pulled him down.
Oh, tied him, as I say.
Yeah, that's right. So Ider takes the ball here in the second quarter. They have it up on the wrong 28-yard line. Crossville will have some good defensive stands right here. Hand off around the right end, number 36. He makes his way up to about the 37-yard line.
He kind of got caught off position that time. Wallace was on the right side, and Hustle tried to get to the left side and was undermanned on this side.
That'll set up second down, 1 yard to go for the Ider Hornets. And they break out of huddle. Number 10, Jonathan Leonard, comes up under center. He takes the snap.
Snap up the middle.
Play right up the middle. I believe he's got his first down. He gains about 4 yards on the play. 4 yards.
Made the stop.
That's just power football, right up the middle. Just run it down the throat. Crossville didn't quite react soon enough to it. Good pickup on the play. Power set up, first down, 10 yards to go.
Patterson looks like he's got something wrong with his helmet there.
And it looks like Crossville's going to take a timeout.
We're going to take a timeout with it. Patterson had something wrong with
his. A lot of substitutions coming in.
I don't believe they're going to. They're not going to. Yeah, I guess they are going to create a timeout.
So it's 10:57 in the second quarter. Crossville Lions take a timeout. We'll be back in just a few moments. In the second quarter, Crossville had just taken a timeout, had some substitution problems, and one of the players had a helmet problem, chin strap problem. They took a timeout.
Well, Jason went in, got tackle.
Ider was up to the wrong about 42-yard line, first down, 10 yards to go. Leonard under center. We got
legal motion.
Looks like we got penalties all over the place. Probably two men in motion. None of this, Crossville makes a good start. And that's what the call is. Illegal motion on Ider. That would set him back a little bit.
And from Nashville, Tennessee, with 5 minutes going
and a half,
is Alabama.
I think we're going to decline it. Morris, it looks like he lost about 2 yards on the play, so the second and 12 instead of first and 15.
Well, that's exactly what's going on.
Good job by the coaching staff.
That sets up about second down for the Ider Hornets. About 11 yards to go.
Lost about yards to two.
Ider comes out, comes up for the line of scrimmage. Crossville's defense is ready. Leonard takes the snap.
Converse this way, got him out here.
That's a good play by the defense. We'll go reverse real well.
Jay Holcomb and David Bowman.
Looked like a lot of trickery trying to go on in the backfield. Didn't fool anybody with Crossville.
Lost about 2 yards on it. Good play.
Third down and about 14 yards to go. We're here in the second quarter. Crossville's ahead, 7-0.
You definitely got to stay home, your defensive end. You never know when the reverse is coming.
Ider in a passing situation, we'll see what to do. You got number 20 coming in motion. They go out on the pass. Leonard drops back.
Oh!
And it's almost intercepted.
Oh, well, almost intercepted. Still goes up 4th and 14.
Oh, well, had a chance to make a good interception on that play. The ball was just thrown a little bit low. He couldn't get down there to it.
He's in the right position, though.
Wasn't anywhere around where the receiver was.
Mikey Wade goes back for some punt.
Number 36 for Ider goes back to punt. Heath Pritchett.
To return, number 42, Mikey Wade.
Pritchett takes the snap, good snap. He gets the kickoff, and looks like he's not going to try very far. Crossville Lions just move out of the way of it. Takes a good roll for Ider. All the way down to about the 28-yard line. We'll be back in just one moment.
Ider Stadium. Score 7-0 in favor of Crossville Lions. 9:25 into this second quarter. Crossville takes over after an Ider punt. Punt wasn't very good, Mike, but he got a good roll on it.
Yeah, he got a good kick.
They're down about the 28-yard line.
But caught him back to pass. Through the
He runs right under the route. He's got his man.
Good catch for Harper. Caught it about 5 yards there. 35-yard line.
Todd made a good catch on that play. He had his defender all over him.
Todd threw the defensive end there. He rolled out. He handed off. He's done a really good job of play placing tonight.
And sets up about second down, 4 yards to go across the line. They're right up near the 34-yard line in their own territory. Ben Coggin comes out. He's under the center. Looks like he's just going to have a...
First and outside. Nice move. Look at that move. He fumbled the ball.
McAway fumbles the ball on a handoff there.
Bless his heart. Made a fine run.
Looked like it just popped out of his hand when he started to get tackled, Mike. Didn't have his hand over the end of the ball, and it just popped out. If he'd been a little bit closer to the sideline, I believe that ball would have went out of bounds. No chance of that. Ider Hornets take over on the fumble on the Crossville 41-yard line. First down and 10 here in the second quarter. Ider comes up to the line of scrimmage. Number 10 has it. He gives it to number 25 right up the middle. Keith Pritchard takes the ball down. Good gain of about 6-7 yards on the play. They've run that play a lot tonight, Mike. Maybe Crossville will figure that out. Second down, about 4 yards to go for Ider. Brent Tinker takes the ball. He takes it over the left side. He's going to be awful close to the first down, but I don't think he has it yet. Maybe a yard short, a couple of yards short on the play. Brings up at about third down. 1 yard to go. Looks like they're going to bring the chains in and measure for a first down, Mike. I don't believe he has it. And the officials come in with a chain. They'll mark it off, see just how close it is.
Dyer up a little like he's trying his shoulder there a little. He's going out. A little short.
Hope he's all right. We need him in the ball game. Third down for the Ider Hornets. About less than a yard to go. They come up to the line of scrimmage. Crossville sets the defense. Need to stick it in there and knock them backwards now. Got number 20 in motion. And it's a play right up the middle. Fullback right up the middle. Looks like he's got a good gain on the play.
Robin and a whole host of more.
Wasn't nothing fancy about that, Mike. Just a handoff right up the middle of the fullback. Crossville just got caught back on the heels a little bit.
About 16.
Looks that way. First down. Ider Hornets, 10 yards to go on the 16-yard line on the Crossville side. 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. Short gain on the play. Maybe a couple of yards. Good stop. Five-yard pickup on the play. Didn't look like he made that much.
No, I know. Patterson on the stop. The whole middle.
Second down, 5 yards to go. Number 10, Jonathan Leonard, comes up under center. He hands the ball off, going around the right side. Number 36, Keith Pritchett takes the ball.
Little blitz up the middle, caught us off guard.
Looked like they caught us in a situation that was worse for us. Had a blitz going up the middle, and that left that outside. Pretty vulnerable. First down for the Ider Hornets. 5 yards to go, making it to the end zone. Once again, just a handoff right up the middle of the fullback. Just a small gain on the play.
Official timeout, he breaks.
With 5 minutes and 58 seconds to go in this second quarter, the officials take a official timeout for a heat break. We'll be back after these messages. And we're back here at the Ider Stadium. 5 minutes, 57 seconds to go in the second quarter. Ider on the drive. They're down on about the 3-yard line.
Hope we don't try to go outside. We get sucker in.
Second down. They hand off.
Touchdown.
And they go in and score. Ider takes the ball, drives it down the field, Mike. Nothing fancy about that. Just a handoff right up the middle.
A good drive on the floor.
Defense stuck it in there. They didn't gain much, but just enough to get it across the end zone. Ider makes the extra point. We'll have a tie ball game here in the second quarter. Heath Pritchard's going to try the extra point. And the bobble to snap. Heath Pritchard takes the ball and is down by Cody O'Neill. The ball goes loose.
Good play. Good
and
play.
The play's dead right there.
Big score right for Hyatt.
So still here in the second quarter, Ider makes a drive, goes in to score 6 points, but can't come away with the extra point. The score remains Ider 6, Crossville 7. And we're back here at the Ider Stadium, 5 minutes, 46 seconds to go in the second quarter. Ider just drove down the field and scored. They're about to kick off. Number 42 for Crossville is back. Mikey Wade, he's the deep man. Number 22,
28
up.
Mikey taking one, man.
Ider's lined up for the kickoff. Like to see one of those deep backs back there take the ball, create a seam somewhere and run through it. Get good field position. The kick is up. Mikey Wade takes the ball. About his 20-yard line, he goes around the right end. He's tackled in there by a whole host of Ider players. He gains maybe 5 yards on the play. Crossville will take the ball and start on their own 25-yard line.
We need a drive right here. 5 minutes. 5 minutes going to quarter. We need to drive it down and score before half.
Crossville drove the ball pretty well. They've mixed it up. Handoff plays, around the end, pass plays. Seemed like what's worked best for them is when they try to outrun the defensive ends around the end. Got enough speed back there to do that. Number 13, Clint Cobbin comes up under center. He hands the ball off to Mikey Wade around the left side. He's got a seam. He's to the 40-yard line, down to the 45. He's going to be tackled in there about the 49-yard line by Ider. Flag laying on the field.
Afraid we got a hold.
That's exactly what it is, be a holding call on Crossville. That sure is going to hurt a good running play by Mikey Wade. Thought he was going to be tackled 10 yards down there, but he spun away from a couple of tacklers. Picked up some more yardage, but all going to be brought back with a holding penalty. That'll set up about 15 yards to go, first down for the Crossville line. They've showed they can do some things tonight if they can cut down on the mistakes. Had an interception down close to the goal line earlier in the first quarter. Had a couple of penalty plays that's negated some good plays.
A holding play was from the point of the foul, too, so that was close to 3 yards beyond the line of scrimmage.
So that sets up 7.
Odell, 17. Good run, Odell.
Cody Odell goes down about the 41-yard line, picks up a first down on the play.
Nice blocking.
Didn't see any flags right there, so that sets up a good play. Good pickup.
Man, we get some things. You can drive a truck through that fast.
That's good. About 20-yard pickup on the play.
Ider took a timeout, Mars.
Ider Hornets take a timeout with 4 minutes, 36 seconds to go in the second quarter. Crossville line 7, Ider Hornets 6. We'll be right back. We're back back now in the second quarter. Crossville has got a pretty good drive going, Mike. Pick up by Cody Odell with about 20 yards on the last play. Sets up first down, 10 yards to go. Crossville on back their own 41-and-a-half-yard line. Line of scrimmage has done real good the last couple of plays.
That's a big hole.
Calvin comes up under center. He hands Odell off. Odell around the right side. He picks up just a couple of yards on the play.
Pritchett.
Looked like he run into a block wall right there just for him.
He's a good ball player.
Pick up about 4 yards on the play. Good spot by the officials. We thank them a lot.
Take it all day.
Cody stuck his head in there and got hit by a brick wall, but tried to spin away from it. Pick up of about 4. Second down, 6 yards to go. Under 4 minutes now in the second quarter. Calvin under center. Cody O'Neill comes around the left end.
Good ride.
Good seam right there on the left side, Mike. Looks like he can drive another truck through there.
Harper shut off it. When he come in motion, he shut off inside. Made a real nice seam for him.
Pickup of about 12, 13 yards on the play. That was set up first down, 10 yards to go. They're inside outer territory now. About the 42, 43-yard line. Crossville on the move, driving down the field, trying to get another score before halftime. Getting close down to 3.5 minutes to go before halftime.
I thought about a pass play, but we sure are running the ball off good right now.
Calvin comes up under center. He takes the pitch back to number 28, Odell, around the right side.
Stuck hard.
He's going to be stopped in there with a gain of maybe 3 or 4 yards. There's a good hole there to begin with, but it closed up real quick.
Good linebacker. 4.
Gain only about 2 yards, maybe. Second down, 8 yards to go. Crossville's got a good drive going right here. It looked like the line of scrimmage has blown off real good. Had some men in motion come across and set some good seams, good holes for running backs to run through. They're running the ball hard. Mikey Wade comes back and tailback. Eye formation. Now he scoots over. Calvin under the center. Second down. He's going to throw a pass. Throws it over the middle. Bowman over the middle. He's caught the ball. He's down to about the 22-yard line. Don't see any flags on the play. First down for Crossville.
Nice play.
Good catch in there by Bowman over the middle. Wasn't anybody around him. No defenders trying to keep the ball away from him. Calvin made a good pass. Hit him right in the hands. Right in stride. Nice pickup on the play.
2.5 minutes to go. We ought to be able to stick it in here. We got most of that clock.
Crossville now on Ider's about 22, 23-yard line. First down to go. Calvin comes up under center. Got a split backfield. He goes to a pass. He tries to throw it out here in the flat. Number 10, Dustin Powell. Mike, that's a hard pass to throw. Just about all quarterbacks can tell you that's one of the hardest passes to throw out here in the flat. You have to throw it just precise to get in the man's hand.
Ball timing.
Didn't work that time. Incomplete. Still set. Second down now, 10 yards to go. 2 minutes, 17 seconds was the clock he stopped on the incomplete pass.
Patterson's coming in for Dyer up at fullback.
Josh Wallace splits out to the left side. Calvin under center, pitch back to Mikey Wade around the left end. He's got a good seam around this left side.
One man.
He picks up maybe 5 yards on the play. Good pickup on the play. He just beat him around this left end over here, Mike. Mm-hmm. Had some good sealing off. Third down, about 4 yards to go. We're under 2 minutes now before halftime. Mikey Wade going out of the ball game. Number 28, Cody Odell coming in with the play. Then Calvin relays the play to the rest of the team, and now they're going up to the line of scrimmage. Third and 4. They've been running the ball well. We'll see what they do here. We got another pass play, and he's throwing over the middle to Bowman, and it's intercepted again. Intercepted by number 10 for Ider, Jonathan Leonard.
Tough break.
Mike, that sure does negate a good driving down the field by Crossville.
3 turnovers that killed us up there.
We've just made some mistakes tonight that's hurt us in bad times. Get down close to the goal line and something go wrong. They're going to have to go in at halftime and try to cut those things out. Had a good drive down the field. That will be encouraging, though, to the coaching staff. Ider comes out now on offense, number 36 in motion.
At the middle.
Handoff just right up the middle.
Yard.
He may have gained a yard on the play, not much of anything. I'd say that second down, about 9 yards to go. We're now under 1 minute. Forty-five seconds to go before halftime. Crossville 7, Ider 6. Ider's on the drive and deep in their own territory. That may just be trying to run out the clock before halftime. Hand off to the tailback on the right side. Tried to go over the guard and tackle position. Didn't go anywhere. Crossville made a good stop. That'll set up about third down, 9 yards to go.
Crossville's called a timeout. Maybe we can get the ball back just up before half here.
31 seconds to go before halftime. Crossville's going to get the ball back. We'll be back after these messages. We're back here at Ider Stadium. 31 seconds to go before halftime. Crossville leading 7-6. Ider has the ball. Third down, 10 yards to go. Crossville's made some good defensive stops right here. They take the handoff right up the middle. No gain on the play.
Good stick.
Darnell on the stop there. He stuck it right in there. It didn't gain a thing on it. That'll bring up fourth down. 20 seconds to go on the time clock. And it looks like Ider's just going to run the clock out before halftime here, Mike. They're not going to try to go in.
He's picking up the lead. He's really hurt himself.
And that's the end of the first half. Crossville 7, Ider 6. Good ball game so far. We'll be back after these messages.
mallet soloist, Genevieve Smith, our trumpet soloist, Marshall Gilbreth. We thank you for your kind attention.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're about set to get started with the second half between Crossville and Ider. Crossville leads this ball game 7-6. Good hard-fought ball game in the first half. Ider has elected to receive the ball here in the second half. While they're getting set up, kickoff, let me run down a few stats that we have. First downs, Crossville had 9. Ider had 5 first downs. 1 fumble was lost per each team. In some individual stats, Clint Cobbin had... he was 3-for-6 in passing with 2 interceptions, 56 yards total. David Bowman had 50 yards receiving, while Cody Odell had a total of 56 yards rushing.
Corey Ripper had 12 yards rushing, and Todd Harper had 1 yard rushing and 6 yards in passes. Mikey Wade had 54 yards total in rushing. Ripper had no penalties, while Crossville had a total of 12 yards in penalties. And the kick is off, kicked by number 20. He gets up to about the 26-27 yard line. We have the second half underway.
Jamie Gaines on the floor. Pretty good defensive stand right here.
Ida comes out with the ball. They're on about the 27-28 yard line almost. Jonathan Leonard under center. He reverses, hands the ball out of the 22. He goes over the right side for just a couple yard gain. Brent Tucker on the carry.
Sir Holcomb on the tackle. Good stick.
That's a good way to start off the second half, Mike. Only a couple yard gain on there. Defense needs some. Needs a boost right here. Second down, 8 yards to go. Just getting started with the second half. Ider comes up to the line of scrimmage. Number 10 quarterback under center. He turns around, hands the ball off.
Jay Hobble.
Tailback.
Nice play. Lost by 2 yards.
Defense just ruined on that play, Mike. Looks like they read that. Maybe they went in halftime. Looked at some things and made some adjustments. Brings up third down and about 8-9 yards to go.
That was Adam Crossing. Looking.
Ider breaks the huddle. They come to the line of scrimmage. Third down, 9 yards to go. Crossville's defense is set. They made some good stops right here.
Pass.
Number 10 comes out for the pass. He rolls to the right.
Good job.
He's going to take the ball and carry it himself. He only gets about 5 yards on the play. That'll bring up a fourth down. He gets the ball up to about the 34 yard line. Fourth down, 5 yards to go. For Ider, number 36, Heath Pritchett drops back to punt the ball. For Crossville, number 42, Mikey Wade drops back as a deep man to receive the punt. Crossville put up a good defensive stop right there. The punt's in the air, short punt.
Yeah.
Looked like he shanked it off to the right. He hits on about the 45-yard line, rolls across into Crossville territory, and is down by Ider at their own Crossville's 46-yard line. So Crossville takes over after the Ider holders come up short on offense. Can't make a first down and have to punt the ball away.
They stick the ball in the end zone right here. Sure would give us a lot of momentum going in the second half.
Crossville had some good drives the first half, just some penalties and interception, fumble, killed a couple of drives. They could have scored more than what they did. Clint Cobbin, number 13, comes up under center. He hands the ball off to the tailback, Mikey Wade.
Okay,
Ider makes a good stop right there. They lose about 2 yards. Mike, it didn't look like we had any blocking over here on the right side.
Closed up in a hurry.
They just pushed him back. Second down, 12 yards to go. Mikey Wade goes out of the ball game. Cody Odell comes in.
Both of them doing a fine job. They're about equal stats.
They sure did. Both of them, I think, a little over 50 yards. Cody O'Dell takes the ball off to the left side. He goes over the tackle. He makes about 5 yards on the play.
By number 64,
Mikey Wade and Cody O'Dell's running the ball hard tonight. They both stuck it in there. Mikey Wade comes back in the ball game as Cody O'Dell goes out.
Patterson's coming in from the dive rifle fullback.
Josh Wallace also comes into the ball game. He splits out wide to the left side. Crossville's come up now, third down, 8 yards to go. They're right at midfield. Mikey Wade takes a handoff around the right tackle. He's off tackle.
It's close.
I believe he's got the first down, Mike. Right? From right here where we're at, looks like he's right on it.
We didn't get a very good spot, did we? First down. He's
first down.
Right.
He sure did. Well, we got a good spot on that from the officials.
He's asking, Ider's coach asking for it to be measured.
So we're going to try to bring the chains in right now.
It's awful close.
See just how close it is. I don't think Ider's coach was too happy about that first down. The official first signal, so he's asked for the chains to be brought in. Crossville is in Ider territory. They're on about the 44-yard line. Just getting the second half underway. Crossville's first drive of the second half. And it looks like they've come up just a little bit short. It'll be fourth down in just a few inches.
About an inch, looks like.
So the Ider coach made a good call right there to bring the chains in.
Sure, we're getting up first to good quarterback sneak here.
Cody O'Dell brings the play in to clear Cobbin. Fourth down, 1 yard to go on the Ider 44-yard line. Nose of the ball just across the inside 44. Crossville comes up to the line of scrimmage, waiting for the change to be set. Mike, you wouldn't look for any trickery play right here. Just hard-nosed football. Just ram it down.
Yeah. Got a good drive going. No sense.
Clint Cobbin takes the snap. He's going to hand the ball off to Cody O'Dell. He's off to the left side. Good hold right there.
It's a good call, too. They were probably expecting a slam.
Yeah, it looked like when you was looking at the defensive alignment, it looked like the defense was just looking and slam toward the inside, looking for a play up the middle. Cody O'Dell kicked it off around the left tackle and gained up about 5-6 yards on the play. First down, 10 yards to go.
One tackler and he'd been gone.
7 minutes, 51 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Crossville getting a good drive going. Wallace splits out deep to the left side. Clint Cobbin takes the snap. He hands it off to Mikey Wade. Looks it in over the left side. He's picked up 10. He's picked up 15 down to the 20-yard line.
Good job. Hold on the ball.
Had a good hold that time.
Nice play. Pulled the guard and tackle. Led the hole for him. Done a fine job. A
couple of outer defensive men right there. And some of the linemen for Crossville cut them down, created seam. O'Dell just went right off their heels and made some good yardage. Picked up about 15. First down, 10 yards to go.
You got to hurry and get the play going.
Down on about the 21-yard line. Play came in a little bit late. We'll see if they can get it off in time enough. Looks like they will. Hand off once again to Cody O'Dell off the right tackle.
Keeps trying to break it out.
Cody O'Dell.
What's going to happen? He's going to cut one of them up in a minute. He's going to be gone.
Picked up only about 2 yards on the play. About second down, 8 yards to go. Mikey Wade comes back into the ball game. Number 10, Dustin Powell, also returns. Cobbin gives the play out to the rest of the team. They go up to the line of scrimmage. Second down, 8 yards to go. Just inside the 20-yard line. Crossville's got a good drive going here.
Good job, man. Down to the 5-yard line.
Corey Dalrymple had a good run. He had both arms across that ball.
Yeah, it was a good job, Bob.
Number 10, Jonathan Leonard.
Lion did a fine job trapping.
Ider had done some run some trap plays earlier in the ball game. Didn't work very well. You think that may have been about the first trap play Crossville had run? I don't remember another one. Do you mind?
Remember? An
official
timeout for Luke Bate.
with 6 minutes and 6 seconds to go in the third quarter. It looks like the officials are going to take an official timeout. Well, maybe they're not. He's signaling for the clock just to keep running. So we'll not take a timeout right here. Well, now he's signaling for a timeout.
We can't make a mind up.
Maybe he was waiting to get down under the 6 minute mark. We'll be back right after these messages. We're back after the break. Officials took a timeout for the Heat. We're now under 6 minutes to go in this third quarter. Crossville has the ball on the drive. They're down to the 5 yard line. First down to go. Clear back. Pitches back to Michael Wade.
Good job.
Touchdown over the right side. Michael Wade running by hard. Scores in.
That's what you call smash mouth football.
Crossville goes up now. 13-6. Good drive on that play, Mike.
Yeah, that was a good play. You did a good job here on the ball down that time.
Play right across for Kepham off guard, running it one way and then running it back the other way. Had a trap play that they run in there, gained some good yardage. Good drive that time.
We got some good momentum going. We got to keep it.
Try point after, number 35.
If we've done that all now, we just kind of shot ourselves in the foot.
Yeah, just didn't have any major mistakes that time.
Harper's going to try the PAT.
The snap, the hold is good, and the kick is up, and it's good. With 5 minutes and 43 seconds to go in the third quarter, Crossville Lions go up 13-6 over the Ider Hornets. We'll return in just a few moments. Crossville goes up 14-6. Ty Harper has the kickoff. It bounces down to about the 10-yard line. I believe it goes out of bounds. Looks like a flag is down on the far side of the field, about the 10-yard line.
I think they got the option of taking it on the 35 marks or making him kick it over.
Yeah, the kick went out of bounds against Billy, will be against Crossville.
The officials are talking with number 54, 64 for Ida. One of the captains, Nathan Powell. Looks like they're going to have to kick it again. They're bringing them all back. Crossville will line up on the kickoff once again. Todd Harper will tee it back up. Do it again.
It's a 5 yard penalty. That's not a bad idea on Ida's part because they've had good kickoff returns tonight.
He'll have to tee it up now on about the 35 yard line. See how much leg he can put into this thing, get it down close to the goal line anyway.
We need good coverage on this kickoff. Get him back deep.
The official blows his whistle. Todd Harper now lines up to kick it. And the kick is in the air. Looks like a good kick. Down the middle.
Up to five.
He takes it up back to five. Number 22 takes it up. Past the 20, 25, 30. He gets up to 35 yard line. He's tackled there.
Number 40, Tex Martin.
Tex Martin on the stop.
Patterson in there with him. Number 30. We need a good defensive stand here.
First down, 10 yards to go for the Ida Hornets. They come out on the 35 yard line, just across the 35 yard line. Crossville's defense lines up nose to nose with him.
Still split four.
Number 28, he gets the handoff coming around the left side. He avoids two tackles and finally run out of bounds about the 45.
Too much on track that play.
Number 20 came in motion that time, and when the hooded ball, he was just right behind the quarterback, and he just turned around and handed it to him. Nothing fancy about that. Crossville was just late reacting around the end.
Ian got pinned in.
A couple of guys hit him. He just broke through their arms and finally was forced out of bounds. So now it sets up second down, less than a yard to go for Ider. Just inside their 45 yard.
There's a motion right here. We got it.
Yeah, looks like a flag on the play. They'll run the ball straight up the middle. A couple yard gain on the play.
Everybody's moving. Full snap.
We're about 2 men in motion that time. Have a motion man number one going across. Fullback just got a little bit edgy and took off a little bit too soon.
It should help us. Should make it second and six now.
Crossville takes the penalty. Backs him up about 5 yards. Just inside now the 30-yard line. It's second down for the Ida Hornets. About 6 yards to go. Ida comes back up to the line of scrimmage. Jonathan Leonard's under center.
Oh, looks like Crossville
gets right up the middle.
Look at that right there.
He picks it out to slip down to 36. Try to go around the right side. Looks like Crossville just collapsed in the backfield back there.
It's good timing. I don't know if he wrote. Dive up. I couldn't tell if it was dive up or not, but he was right at the line of scrimmage and the ball was snapped. Good timing.
Sets up third down. 8 yards to go for Ider.
Probably Johnson. I'm not sure who that was.
Need a big stand right here by Crossville to get the play back. Quarterback takes the ball with an option play around the left. Quarterback keep it holding. And he's going to run out of bounds at about the 40-yard line.
Down up the rim goes to Mikey Wade and Dusty Darnell. It was Stephen Miller. Knocked him out. That's who it was.
He's running out of bounds on the 38-yard line. Sets up right. Fourth down. Have to go into punt formation now. Good team tackling that time. All right, let's go through the little guys over here on this side. Didn't let him get around the corner and cut it up. Just running out of bounds.
Got to get to the ball.
Mikey Williams. Mikey Williams now deep for the punt. Punt's up. Pretty good punt. Real high.
Yeah, we got to bounce that
back. 37-yard line.
Let's look. Go.
Mikey Williams picks the ball up. He's in the way with it.
We'll do that here.
Not nothing wrong in trying to do that. The defense just kind of.
No. Let's say who. No, they've got to burn it. They've got to blow it dead.
Well, we're like little Ider's players. They touch the ball.
Right, yeah, they get the chance of where they touch it or where they want it. So.
But then Mikey Wade picked the ball up and ran with it. Didn't go very far, but ran the bad car.
So we get the ball back here where they first touched the ball.
So Crossville looks to bring the ball back to here where it was originally touched. But it'll be about the 38-yard line of Crossville. First down, 10 yards to go. Had a good drive last time they had the ball. Drove it all the way downfield. No mistakes.
Used a lot of clock, too. That's key.
Clock's now 4 minutes to go in this third quarter. Crossville's up 14-6.
Ball down. Ball.
Looks like a fumble on the play. Flags on the play. All kind of confusion.
A little legal procedure.
Ball recovered by number 13, Clay
Crawford.
It's okay.
Penalty
will be against
Crawford.
We'll get the ball back. That's the main thing.
5-yard penalty on the play. That's set up. First down, 15 yards to go. Illegal motion against Crossville. Josh Wallace comes in with the play. Dustin Powell goes out on the play. Wallace splits out to the right side. Clint Collin under center. First down. He pitches back to Mikey Wade around the left side. Defense just collapsed in the backfield.
That's
good.
Looked like the man tried to pull a guard or something and wore that guard pulled. Defensive man just ran right through the hole and dragged him down from behind. Second down, 15 yards.
I was going to get ball to
him. Yes, they do. Good hustling ball team. They're not afraid to stick it in there and hit you. Ida doesn't have a whole lot of players, but from what we understand, the players they've got are good athletes and good hard ball players. We've got a reverse to number 35. Todd Harper takes it around the left end. Picks up pretty good yardage. Maybe picks up about 8 or 9 yards on that run.
Bring up about 36, 37. It's a big third down play right here.
Josh Wallace brings in the play as Dustin Powell goes out. Brings the play in to Clint Cotton as they begin to make their way to the line of scrimmage.
I just got two deep safeties here.
Looks like a passing situation for Crossville. Can he hit it out off the right of the road on the right side of the stand? Get everybody first down at midfield.
Good call for Coach Carmen. Had a two deep safety down there. Safeties were backed up. The time they got up there to make the tackle, they picked up his first down.
It was a good hole right there, Mike.
It was a great hole.
The linemen have been able to create some good seams for the running back. They've been able to pick up some good yardage so far.
Good play.
Mikey Wade now goes out of the ball game as number 30. Kevin Patterson comes in. Corey Dalrymple goes out of the ball game. First down, 10 yards to go, just inside Ider territory. Crossville leading this ball game here in the third quarter, 14-6. Clint Cobbin takes the ball, hands it out to Corey. Cody Dalrymple.
Yeah, it was strong on that time. They caught us.
Ribbon loose is about 10 yards, yard and a half on the play.
Linebackers were coming with him. Probably not enough men at the point of attack.
Preston Powell goes out as Josh Wallace brings the play in. Second down, 12 yards to go for Crossville. That brought the ball back on Crossville, side of the field. They're playing right out midfield. Clint Cotton takes the ball. He pitches back to Cody O'Neill. Gets tripped up after a gain of probably 45 yards.
By number 25, Keith Richards. Right, that's the same that time.
One of the defenders, I just got him by the shoestrings there, the shoe, and tripped him up a little bit, and he'd have some good yardage to pick up. Looks like the officials are going to take a timeout. 37 seconds to go in this third quarter. We'll be back right after these messages. We're back now. Crossville takes the ball. It's third down, 8 yards to go. Clint Cobbin takes the ball, hands it off to Michael Wade. Right here, see him around there. Right side. Oh, he's fanned right down by number 10 and about the 32-yard line.
Great blocking.
Good hard running back one time with Mikey Wade. He hit that hole and he was in full speed.
Dustin Powell and Harper made the super blocks on the corner.
Josh Wallace brings in the play. First down, 10 yards to go. Crossville on the move, down to the ladder, 33-yard line.
The ties were right out on Smalls here in the third quarter. He's got a good drive, man.
That's the end of the third quarter, with Crossville leading this ball game 14-6. On the move, deep in out of territory. We'll return just in a moment.
For the beginning of the fourth quarter, Crossville on the move. Clint Cobbin takes the ball, hands it off to Mikey Wade over the right side. Pick up of about 4 or 5 yards.
It's a good run. Not much of a hold. Hard running. You know, our offensive line has done a great job.
We're going into the fourth quarter now, Mike, and it just seems like Crossville has pretty well dominated this game.
They have.
They've had some mistakes that's hurt them in key points, but even other than that, they've pretty much controlled this game on offense. Ate up some precious time off the clock.
We got some good drives. We shut them down on defense.
Second down, 6 yards to go for Crossville. At the outer 30-yard line, Cody O'Dell takes the ball, goes up the middle, gain of about 2 yards.
Hard running there.
That'll set up a third down, about 4 yards to go.
Big third down. We're on about the 27. Yeah.
Looks to be that. Wallace and Mikey Wade coming into the ball game, bring the play in to Clint Cobbin. Offense sets up. Cobbin takes the ball, hands it off to Mikey Wade. He's off to the left
side. Good cut. Good cut.
Cuts back up the field.
Picked up his first down.
Gets down inside the 20-yard line. number. Good hard running in there by Mikey Wade.
He said cover the ball up when he got in traffic. That's the way he's supposed to do it.
Dustin Powell checks into the ball game. That was a good cut. He cut back across the game, gained a few yards on the play. Cody Odell now comes into the game, relieves Mikey Wade. First down for the Crossville Lions at the Ider 19-yard line. 10 minutes, 17 seconds to go in the ball game. Crossville on the move once again. Pitches back to Cody Odell.
Nothing.
Around the right side. Try to get around the end. Nothing there.
It's a good defense stand. 36,
loss of about 2 yards on that play. Didn't have enough people, look like, out there on that end trying to block.
He stick us in the end zone. Give us some cushion.
Crossville comes up to the line of scrimmage. It's second down, 12 yards to go. Colvin under center. Cody Odell in the backfield. Tailback. No, it's Mickey.
Pass. Harper wide open.
He's got Harper wide down open. To the end zone.
Close.
I think Colvin made a good pass on the play. Harper just wasn't quite able to hold on to it right on the goal line. And it looks like he's hurt over there close to the goal line.
It does.
Number 35.
Officials don't even see it yet.
Todd Harper over there. They're going to take a timeout.
How do they see it?
10 to Todd. May have just got a cramp. Look like trying to dive out of bounds right there. So with that incomplete pass, the clock is stopped with 9 minutes, 23 seconds to go in this fourth quarter. We'll be back in just a moment. And we're back here in the fourth quarter. Had a timeout as Todd Harper was hurt over there on the goal line on that incomplete pass, but it looks like he's all right, Mike.
Yeah, he's like he shook it off.
He got up, run back to the sidelines. Third down, 12 yards to go for the Crossville Lions at the outer 20-yard line. Clint Colvin takes the ball. We've got a fake reverse on the play. Clint Colvin misses a few tackles, finally gets it off, passes toward the end zone. It's incomplete. Just threw it just out of bounds, out of the reach of the receiver.
We got fourth down.
Good coverage that time by the Ida Hornets. Clint Colvin had to run around back there in the backfield. Couldn't find anybody open. Pretty much just threw that in the way.
So Harper's going to try field goal. 32. About 31 yards, right?
It'd be close. I was watching him in the pregame, Mike. He's got a good leg on him. I think he's able. He's got a good enough leg to make this field goal. Crossville's going to take a timeout. We're going to talk about this field goal. We'll return just after these messages. We're back in the fourth quarter. 9 minutes, 14 seconds to go in the ball game. Looks like number 35, Todd Harper, is going to be lined up. We've got a 37, 38 yard field goal. The snap, the player holds down.
Good punt.
Just didn't make it. No good on the field goal attempt. Mike, didn't look like he got out of his leg. Didn't look like there was an extension on his leg. Went off to the right side. No highs to it. Ider takes over on downs right there on the 20-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go for Ider.
Big defensive stand here.
Defense gets set. Number 10, Jonathan Leonard, comes up under center for the Ida Hornets.
He takes the ball, hands it off to number 22. Number 22, Fuller with the play.
We got the ball.
Takes over on the third.
Number 44,
Mark Johnson. Good job, Mark.
Ider tried to stick the ball in on the right side. He just got the ball stripped out. Mark Johnson jumped on the ball, a little pile of players. Crossville comes up with the ball once again on the 20-yard line. They take over.
Good play right there.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Stick it in the end zone now. There was a little bit of his clock.
Mikey Wade's going to line up his tailback. Clint Colvin lines up under center. First down for the Crossville Lions.
We're going out.
Mikey Wade, right up the middle on the handoff, just nothing fancy about it. Hard-nosed football.
Yes.
Gained of about 10 yards on the play. Line of scrimmage, he's done a good job. He is creative. A good hole right there, and he hit it hard.
The kids may be cracking up. I'm noticing some of the college ball games today. Some of the kids are cracking up, having problems with work.
It's hot weather, I'm sure. Even though it's a cool night tonight, it feels pretty good up here, but down on the field, I'm sure them guys are pretty hot. Second down, 1 yard to go. 8 minutes to go in this ball game. Crossville leading 14-6. Clint Colvin under the center, hands the ball off to Mikey Wade. He tries to go around the right end. Runs into a Ider defensive player there. Don't think he picked up anything, but
I don't know what he got.
Third down on the play. 2 yards to go now for the first down.
Listen, I think we're down in four down territory, unless we're going to set Piper try again anyway.
Ball rests right in the middle of the field on about the Ider 13-yard line. Dustin Powell brings the play in. Crossville's had pretty good success right here in this position, Mike.
Well, if we get down here in the red zone, we're going to stick about in the end zone.
Colvin pitches by the center, old man. Goes around the left hand side.
There we go, first down, Morris.
Had a good seam right there on this left hand side.
We did.
The official signals first down.
I think that clock up there.
Clock just keeps running. It's now right at 7 minutes to go in this ball game.
We went to 6, 7 yard line.
7 yard line. Josh Powell brings the play in. Josh Wallace, number 11, brings the play in. He splits out wide to the right side. First down on 7 yard line. Cover all the way up, takes the ball.
Talking about a number on that screen.
Ider's defense just came on around the end that time and caught him in the backfield. He'll lose about 3 yards on that play.
Yeah. I was going to be good on those players.
Ball lays on the 10-yard line. Second down for Crossville. They just keep eating this time clock up all night.
Mm-hmm. I love it.
They go up to the line of scrimmage now on second down. Looks like we got a flag on the play. We've got a delay game. Play was late coming in from the sidelines. Didn't get up to the line of scrimmage on time. Got a delay game. That'll cost them 5. Back them up again. Still second down. Now the ball rests on about the 15-yard line. Mike, once again, they're shooting yourself in the foot with penalties and mistakes.
We got to put the ball in the zone.
They had a first down on about the 5-yard line, 7-yard line.
7, yeah.
Colvin drops back to pass. He throws a pass to Harper, number 35. Throw was a little bit high. Harper had to go up, bounced off his hands.
We have a timeout.
Looks like we're going to have a heat break by the officials. 5 minutes, 56 seconds to go in this ball game. We'll be back. Crossville 14, Ider 6. We're back now after the official timeout for a heat break. 5 minutes, 56 seconds to go in this ball game. Crossville's on the move. We're down to about the outer 15-yard line. Third down. Pitch back to Mikey Wade. Looks like he's going to pass the ball. Wide open.
Let's go.
Touchdown. Number one, Josh Wallace.
Good call.
Sit down by Mikey Wade. Good call by Coach Garvin.
It was a real call. He's been doing that split all night long. And finally knocked it down, time to pull.
Mikey Wade just took the ball, just went around the right side just a little bit, stopped, pulled up, and hit Josh Wallace. Nobody around him in the end zone. Good play.
That's a good play there, Mikey too.
Coach Coleman must have saw something during that kick timeout that he could do that.
Well, you know, they might have been sweet ball two more times, though.
Crossville's up now, 20-6 over Ida Hornets. Todd Hawk was going to try to attempt the PAT.
Fourth quarter. It is Vanderbilt 19, Alabama 12.
Low lined up, the snap, got the hold down.
17.
Not a very good kick, and he misses it. He is shaking off to the right side just a little bit.
Yeah.
5 minutes, 50 seconds to go in this ball game in the fourth quarter. Crossville ahead, 20-6. We'll return in just a moment. We're back in this fourth quarter, 5 minutes, 50 seconds to go. Crossville just drove down the field. Mikey Wade took a sweep around the right side, throwed it in the end zone, wide open. Number 11, Josh Wallace, 20-6. Crossville leads. Todd Hopper sets the ball up on the tee, ready for the kickoff. Hatter's knee in the back deep. Hopper kicks the ball high. Good kick. Good high kick. He takes it up right to the 5-yard line.
Good job.
He takes it up right to the 25-yard line.
Pretty good job.
And he is stopped by number
28.
It looked like one of the other players was actually even holding on to his jersey, but that didn't keep him from making the stop. Ida takes the ball about the 26-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Number 36 is in motion.
Johnson on the blitz.
He's got a man open out here in the flat.
Oh, man. Good play, man. Bowman.
Bowman made a good play on that.
Right to gut interception.
Number 10, the quarterback, Jonathan Leonard. Rolled around to the right-hand side. He had a man open, but just couldn't throw the ball. After to him, Bowman made a good play, tipping it out of the way. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ida may realize they may have to do some passing now to get back in this ball game. Time running out.
Well, that's going to benefit us too, Mark.
Just under 5.5 minutes to go.
Coming first, coming this way. First, up ahead. Ball there, ball. Yes. Good job, David Bowman.
You're right, number 21. David Bowman came in with a hit, knocked the ball out. Number 34 for Crossville comes up with the ball. Corey Dalrymple. He comes up limping a little bit, but I bet he's glad that he's got the ball. Crossville takes over after the fumble. In out of territory, 25-yard line. Crossville's got the ball now, the outer, and the outer 25-yard line.
Is now 24 Alabama, back around
19. Crossville takes the ball now.
All right.
Clean Black takes the ball. Number 43, Mikey Wade has a hand down.
Mikey Wade. It's
good old running, Mikey.
He may get a yard, maybe 2 yards on that play.
It looked like the defensive player right there looked like Crossville Wade. And a fine guy.
He didn't pick up much on that. He didn't pick up much on that play, Mike. They were in no gain. Second down, 10 yards to go.
Eating that clock up, Marsh. That clock's a much fun right now.
All they got to do is just keep it on the ground. Maybe try to inch toward the end zone, get another score out of the end zone. Number 30, Kevin Patterson. Good hard running right up the middle.
Good job, Kevin Patterson.
Good yardage on that play. 15 yards anyway.
About the 9-yard line.
9-yard line. First down. There we go.
correction. Alabama did not score, so the score is still 19-17 Vanderbilt.
We're now under 4 minutes to go in this ball game. Clay Cobbin waiting for the play to come in. They've had a couple of by way of game penalties, and looks like it's a little late coming in this time. They break the hole, come up to the line of scrimmage.
Clay's done a good job in that run offense.
He sure has. He's done a good job.
He's been a good leader.
And there's
the
flag.
Flag's
down.
Against Crossville.
That's about the third delay game Crossville's had this time.
First game, we're going to get it.
That backs them up 5 yards.
With 9 minutes left.
Brings them outside the 10-yard line.
Alabama has just kicked the field goal and gone ahead 20-19.
That stopped the clock with 3 minutes, 28 seconds to go in this ball game. Cross was up 20-6 over Ider. Clay Cobbin gets the ball. He hands it off to Cody O'Brien. He's running right up the middle. Good job. Oh boy, gets inside the 5-yard line.
How about the 4-yard line?
Tackle made by 55 Todd Phillips.
Good ball running over there.
I don't know who was right there in that middle for Crossville. Made some good blocks, created a good hole, and he hit the hole and went right up the middle.
Harrison Bach and Gary Scott and Matt Bibby and Jason Cass and Justin Bowden did a fine job. Making a lot of big holes.
They've had a few breakdowns on the line of scrimmage. Ider's gotten the backfield a few times. But overall, Crossville's offensive line has done a fine job of blocking, creating some holes, and allowing the running back to hit it.
Okay,
once again, Cody O'Dell off to the right side, around the end.
Tackle made by 22.
Just a minimum pickup there. Picks up maybe a yard. That'll bring up third down.
About 4 yards, I think.
About 4 yards to go.
Keeps the clock moving. About 2:19 going to ball game.
Play comes in from Dustin Powell, number 10. Clock just winding down. They're just taking the time coming up to the line of scrimmage. They've had some delay penalties, but that may have actually worked in their favor, running some time off.
Touchdown.
Just gets across the line. Touchdown. Crossville.
Man, that offensive line was doing a fine job tonight. Clears on the offense good, and the backs really put a big effort into it.
Now stop the clock at 2 minutes and 2 seconds. Crossville now up 26. Ider is 6. Todd Harper line up.
Oh, that's
Corey Templeton.
Corey Templeton.
He's lined up going to try the PAT. Get a little practice in here in the late in the game. The snap. Bible will hold a little bit, but he got it in.
That's right.
And he misses the extra point. With 2 minutes and 2 seconds to go in this ball game, Crossville leads by the Hornets 26-6. We'll be back in 1 moment. In the fourth quarter, Crossville up in this ball game with 2 minutes and 2 seconds to go, 26-6. Todd Harper has teed the ball up, ready to kick it off again to the Ider Hornets. Mike, I'm glad to say Crossville's done this quite a bit in this ball game. Seeing Hopper take the ball up. The kick is up. So we're going to line drive.
Good little kick. Play with time.
Hits the ball back to 15-yard line. Picked up at the 10. Number 12 takes the ball out.
We got the ball here. Find out the other person.
Out of the ball. Pick the ball up one more time. Dustin Powell with
Dustin Powell. Yeah, good job for your fellow.
Good play in there. It looked like
some good hitting going on there, Marshall.
It looked like the other runner had an open seam there for a minute. Then he got converged on the ball, popped out. Boy, we've seen a lot of that happen tonight.
We want to hit people tonight.
Crossroads pretty well took advantage of those times when they've gotten the ball on a turnover.
And we have timeout called by Crossville.
With a 1 minute, 44 seconds to go in this ball game, Crossville takes the ball over on a fumble off the kickoff. They're inside the 30-yard line of Ider. We'll return in just a moment. 4 seconds to go in this ball game.
So we can win, Marsh.
I don't foresee Crossville coming out and doing any passing right now, do you, Mike?
No, I believe they'll keep it on the ground. Got some young kids in there, got lots in there.
Right, number 11, the quarterback. Hands the ball off to number 20, Corey Templeton. Maybe give some of those substitutes a little playing time. They need
a bunch of young kids, that's good for them.
They'll need this for later on in the season. Number 22 comes into the ball game. Stephen Moreland brings the play in. Corey Templeton goes out on the play. No gain on that play. Second down, 10. Getting down to the 1 minute mark.
Got one pick on the fullback. Got the ball.
Wallace takes the ball, hands it off to the fullback. Luke Peek takes the ball off of the right side. No gain on the play.
1 minute, Marsh.
Number 64 comes into the ball game for Crossville. Patrick Walker. He's replacing number 54, Harley Webb. Good hard offensive plays tonight by that offensive line. Corey Templeton comes back into the game. Also, Adam Stanford. I like to see some of these young players getting some playing time. Crossville up. Under 30 seconds to go, 26-6. 20 seconds left in the ball going the ball game. Wallace takes the ball, he hands it to number 20, Corey Templeton. He's down about the 16-yard line.
He's going to pick up the first down.
11 minutes to go in this ball game. And it looks like they're just going to allow the clock to run out. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second.
Oh, man.
He wins this ball game tonight with Ida Hornets, 26-6.
Oh, man. Well, the ball game. That's good for us. I know the kids are really excited to get their first round of ball. Maybe we're going to have a really good year ahead of us.
Good hard fought ball game. Ida had a good scrappy team. We look forward to next week to going home, being in our own stadium. Hope we have just as much success.
That's a 7 more Bulldogs coming in, don't we?
Sure do.